Hey everyone, welcome back. Today, we're diving into a medication you've probably heard of, amoxicillin. It's one of the most commonly prescribed antibiotics, and knowing more about it can help you better understand when and how to use it safely. This video is packed with research-based information that might come in handy, especially during emergencies, so stay tuned till the end. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with others who might benefit from it. Also, you may ask me questions in the comments section. So, what exactly is amoxicillin? Amoxicillin is a type of antibiotic that falls under the penicillin class of drugs. Penicillin-based antibiotics are known for their effectiveness in treating bacterial infections, and amoxicillin specifically is one of the broader spectrum types, meaning it works against a wider range of bacteria than some other antibiotics. So, what is amoxicillin used for? Amoxicillin is commonly prescribed to treat a variety of bacterial infections. Some of the primary infections it's used to treat include respiratory tract infections such as bronchitis and pneumonia, ear infections often prescribed in children for conditions like otitis media, sinus infections or sinusitis, urinary tract infections, UTIs, throat infections including tonsillitis and strep throat, skin and soft tissue infections like cellulitis. It's important to note that amoxicillin is only effective against bacterial infections. It won't work for viral infections like the flu or common cold. All right, let's talk dosage. Keep in mind the exact dosage of amoxicillin depends on the type of infection, the severity, and the patient's medical history. But generally speaking, for adults, the typical dosage for common infections is around 250 milligrams to 500 milligrams every 8 hours, or 500 milligrams to 875 milligrams every 12 hours. In more severe cases, the dosage may increase under medical supervision, especially in cases of respiratory or severe urinary infections. Note: always follow your doctor's prescription. Do not self-medicate. Now, it's very important to talk about contraindications. These are conditions where amoxicillin should either be avoided or used with caution. If you have a known allergy to penicillin or cephalosporin antibiotics, you should not take amoxicillin. Severe allergic reactions, including anaphylaxis, can occur. Make sure to inform your doctor about any past allergies. People with kidney impairment may need dose adjustments, as the kidneys play a big role in excreting this drug. In cases of mononucleosis, commonly known as mono, amoxicillin should be avoided, as it may cause a rash. Now it's important to discuss on its use in pregnancy and elderly patients. Oh, pregnant women. Amoxicillin is generally considered safe during pregnancy, but it's still essential to use it only when prescribed by a healthcare provider. Oh, elderly patients. Elderly patients may also need adjustments, as they're more prone to kidney function decline. Careful monitoring by a healthcare provider is recommended. So, what about its use for infants and children? Well, amoxicillin is frequently prescribed for children, particularly for ear and respiratory infections, but the dosage is carefully calculated based on the child's weight and age. For infants, always consult a pediatrician for the appropriate dose and form of medication. Now, let's know the directions for use. Using amoxicillin correctly can make a big difference in how effective it is and can also reduce the chance of side effects. Here are some general directions to follow. Amoxicillin can be taken with or without food, but if you experience stomach upset, taking it with food might help. It's crucial to finish the entire prescribed course, even if you start feeling better. Stopping early can cause the bacteria to become resistant to antibiotics. Drink plenty of water to help your body process and flush out the medication effectively. If you miss a dose, take it as soon as you remember, unless it's almost time for the next one. Don't double up on doses to make up for a missed one. Amoxicillin comes in a few different forms, so it can be tailored to the needs of each patient. Here are the most common forms available. Tablets and capsules. 250 milligrams, 500 milligrams, and 875 milligrams. Chewable tablets, often for children. Oral suspension, liquid form, ideal for infants and young children who can't swallow pills. Extended release tablets, sometimes used in adults for specific infections like sinusitis. Each form has a different rate of absorption, so it's essential to use the form prescribed by your doctor. Like any medication, amoxicillin can cause side effects. The most common side effects include mild gastrointestinal symptoms, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. Skin rash. If you develop a rash, contact your doctor immediately, especially if it's accompanied by itching or hives. Serious allergic reactions. Rare but serious reactions like swelling of the face or throat, severe dizziness, and difficulty breathing need emergency attention. If you notice any side effects, consult your healthcare provider right away. That wraps up our deep dive into amoxicillin. I hope this video has given you a better understanding of how this medication works, when to use it, and some precautions to keep in mind. Remember, antibiotics are powerful tools, but must be used carefully to prevent resistance and protect our health. If you found this information useful, please like this video, subscribe to our channel for more health and medication insights, and share it with anyone who might benefit. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.